Well, I got some new bearings for this old motor finally. Sounds a little bit better. Got a little paint job on it. The only thing I don't have on there yet is the cooling fan and fan shroud. So shroud has a little bit of rust on it still, a little rust damage. I may have to get another shroud, but that's a minor thing. The sales literature for these motors said it was an extra high torque motor. And I'll show you how high torque. It'll nearly jump off the counter. Also, I got a little switch box here, so I don't have to go plug it in with it on to watch the take off. Brand new capacitors. It has some good starting torque. Sounds a little better with the new bearings too. Can't beat that. We've got the whole motor complete. Looks pretty good from this angle, but there's one little problem. Notice I didn't paint this fan housing. It's not worth painting. A little bit of a termite infestation back here on this side. So eventually I'll find another housing for that. Probably find that before I end up needing the motor, but that's what you get for a free motor. One more test here, and then I'll be done with it. Even with the hole in it, it still moves plenty of air. Blows out here and runs along the outside of the motor. Feel air coming out all the way around it. One fan on the inside circulating air to transfer it to the shell. Second fan on the outside blows air across the shell to cool the motor, dissipate the heat. Got a reset button here if it overloads or overheats. Circuit breaker will trip and it requires a manual reset. It's a far cry from the way it was when I got it, I'll tell you that. Can't complain about the way it runs.